Hello, it's Professor Mueller again, and I wanted to make a quick video here to address a situation I'm seeing over and over again. It looks like when students are cropping their images, they are cropping to a variety of aspect ratios. So I see a lot of inconsistency. A person might turn in three square pictures, two pictures that are 2x3 aspect ratio, one that's panorama. There's just a free-for-all of aspect ratios. And I've been talking in my class about this, and it's probably a good idea to stick with the aspect ratio that your camera originally shoots at. I mean, I know you can set different aspect ratios in your camera, but by default, your camera will capture at its largest file and whatever that aspect ratio is sort of standard for your camera. For most cameras, this is 2x3. And when I talk about an aspect ratio, I'm talking about the relationship between the short edge and the long edge. So this particular picture just happens to be 2x3. So if this were 2 inches, this would be 3 inches. Another way to say this, and kind of an old school way to say it, is this aspect ratio is 1x1.5. 1x1.5 or 2x3, same thing. But it's based on a 35mm negative. So most of your digital cameras are capturing like this. Some are capturing 3x4. I just don't think it's a good idea to have a variety of aspect ratios represented in a small body of work, such as the Black and White Project or anything else that you're trying to kind of show some continuity in. It's a little distracting. It draws attention to itself. So I thought I would show you, just make sure you know how to crop, use the crop tool while maintaining the original aspect ratio. Let me also say this, that it's best, absolutely best, if you are not doing much cropping to your pictures at all. If you place that restriction on yourself, then as you're photographing, you'll be more attentive to your composition. You'll think, well, if I wanted to be closer, I'd walk over there closer. And that's usually a better way to go. Once you start cropping, you're eliminating part of your image file and you're reducing the quality. So keep that in mind. Try to do your composition in camera to the best of your ability. Sometimes, you know, a little judicious crop is called for. You might have to, you know, remove something on the very edge of the frame that you hadn't seen, but really, we're talking about composition in this class, and one of the things is to trace your eye around all four edges of the frame before you make the picture in the first place. So that will eliminate a lot of these cropping needs. But here, let me show you in Camera Raw first. And the reason I'm showing you in Camera Raw is because it's really difficult to figure this out in Camera Raw. It took me a long time to figure out how to do it. They do not make it very simple. So in Camera Raw, you see I have an image. This is the original image. It's a raw file. And I'm going to go up to here to the crop tool. And when I hover over the crop tool, it says crop tool. But I'm going to click and pull down. Click and hold. And I'm going to go to normal. I'm sorry, that's not true. Let me back up. I didn't prepare super well for this because I just wanted to get it done today. If you go to normal, normal is not what you want. So if I click on normal, you see there I've activated normal. Now it's going to let me crop any way I want. It's just sort of a free crop. I'm going to hit escape to get out of that. I could crop it like this. I'm going to hit escape again. It just lets me do whatever I want. That's not a good idea. So we're going to hold this down and we're going to take this off normal. I guess you have to choose something else to take it off normal. So these are other aspect ratios. 1:1 is square. 2:3 is sort of your standard crop that most of you have. You might have 3:4. You can make custom ones as well. But the way to do it in Camera Raw, as far as I can tell, and somebody can correct me if I'm wrong, is to first guess what your aspect ratio is. I know, sounds crazy. I know this says constrained to image, but it doesn't work the way you would think. So I'm gonna guess wrong, actually. I'm gonna guess 3:4. And now that will constrain my crop. As I pull out, it's forcing it to be 3:4. No matter what size it is, it's 3:4. That's the aspect ratio. And I'm going to pull that out, and I'm going to try to overlay that over the entire image. You can pull any of these corners. So I'm going to bring this up. I'm going to try to overlay over my entire image. But you see it won't do it. There's this area over here that's falling outside the crop. That means that my image is not 3:4 aspect ratio. And that's kind of how I figured out how to use Camera Raw. So guess and see if you can fit it on the entire frame first. If you can fit the entire frame without eliminating any of the image, then you've suddenly learned what the aspect ratio is of your images. So I'm going to hit Escape on that, and I'm going to go up to the crop, and I'm going to select 2 to 3 this time. And now I might as well just start from the corner here and drag. And if I hold down Shift, I thought I could move that. I'm going to pull this out, and I'm going to try to just pull up these corners, and look at that. So I could overlay this crop, this 2:3 aspect ratio crop, on my entire image. That means, yes indeed, this is a 2:3 aspect ratio file. Now, once you've learned that, and if you want to do a crop, that's the one you should use. So if I wanted to crop a little bit, let's say, for instance, I don't like this green leaf up here. I happen to really like it, but for the purposes of this demonstration, let's say I want to take that out. I take it out, I hit done, and then it goes away because it's Camera Raw, so we can't bring that back. Let's see. There. I double-clicked it. I brought it back. I reopened it in Camera Raw, and it's gone. But it's the same aspect ratio. So if I follow this procedure for all of my crops, then all of my pictures will look like they belong together. Also, there's a funny thing in photography where if you are making up your own aspect ratios, if you're just cropping with the free crop all the time, and you're making up on the fly whatever you want, it just doesn't look right to people who are used to looking at photographs. Anyway, continuity is your friend in this case, I think. And I think you should stick with whatever aspect ratio your camera is delivering, okay? So first of all, try not to crop. Try to do that composing in the camera. Secondly, if you're cropping, make all the crops the same aspect ratio. Now I'm going to show you in Photoshop real quick. Jump into here. So that was Camera Raw since I was working on a RAW file. This is a PSD file. Let me make it a little smaller. I'll fit this in here. Okay, so there's my full frame PSD.PSD file. And the crop in Photoshop, as opposed to Camera Raw, makes a lot more sense. So now if I want to crop, I go to the crop tool over here in Photoshop. Some of you are using Photoshop. Most of you are using Camera Raw for this kind of stuff. But if you click and hold down on this, you can choose the crop tool. You might see that it's, you know, you might go over there and find that it's the slice tool. In Photoshop, there are often a number of tools hidden under the same tab. So we're going to go to the crop tool, and this is beautiful. This choice up here, original ratio. So original ratio, that just solves your problem. You don't even have to guess. So once you have original ratio shown, yep, my startup disk is almost full. It's all of your photographs. It's your fault. Now, as I do my crop, it will constrain to the original ratio, and I don't have any problem whatsoever. Okay, so if you're working on the RAW file, now you know how to do it in Camera Raw. If you're working in Photoshop, you also know how to do it there. And in Lightroom, so now we're in Lightroom. Oops, so let me close that out. Yep, maybe too many things going on here at once. Lightroom is, I think, the easiest of all. You're in the develop module. You go to the crop tool, which I'm hovered over right now, and it says crop overlay tool, or you could use R on the keyboard. I click that, and you want to look right here under aspect. So what you want is for this to say as shot. There are other choices in here, but what you want is as shot, and you want to lock that aspect ratio. If this little padlock is open, then I can crop freely, which I don't want. So I'm going to hit Escape on that, and I'm going to go back to the crop tool, and I'm going to say, actually, original will work as well, but there are reasons to choose as shot, so I do that. and I lock this just by clicking on it. And now when I crop, it will maintain the aspect ratio of my original file. So please, this is sort of an emergency video. I really want you guys to start being very consistent about your aspect ratios. Thank you very much. Talk to you later. Bye.